What is happening? The polls have tightened to the point now where you're looking at a real opportunity in a state that the registration numbers clearly favor the Democrats. I mean, you're looking at a 2-to-1 advantage among registered major party voters, and then you got another couple of million unaffiliated voters. What do you think is working, and how are you making this race so competitive?
No, exactly, Bill. On where the state of the race is today, basically how we see it, whether it's the Quinnipiac or other polls, our own internal stuff, if you look at likely voters, this is like a dead heat. You know, this is where we've gotten to the point now where the people are starting to pay attention. They realize, I think two factors are really driving people's views are, one, people are fed up. They're fed up by saying, we've been embarrassed, and we put up with a lot to live in New Jersey. We're tough people. We put up with a lot, and we love New Jersey, but he's gone too far. He's embarrassed us. You know, the whole Senate Ethics Committee stuff, violating federal law, abusing the power of his office, all the stuff that people are going to, by the time that November 6th comes, they're going to know how bad this guy has been involved in corruption for 35 years. But secondly, and almost as important, is people want action. They want results. People in New Jersey want a fair deal, whether it's in Trenton or Washington. And clearly in Washington for 25 years, the people of New Jersey, we've not gotten a freaking fair deal. And this guy has no credibility to say, starting next January, I'm going to do better for you. I may have failed for 25 years for delivering for the people of New Jersey. Mm-hmm. My track record is getting things done.
Let me ask you, Bob, what would you say would be one of the first things? I mean, we talk about the difference between Washington and Trenton, and certainly there's a lot that can be done. But what do you see as your first priority if you win? And again, these are questions I don't think anybody was going to be asking, quite honestly, a year ago, because no one saw this on the radar. I think people underestimated just how sick and tired people were of these corrupt insiders and all these allegations. And then you mentioned that the Senate actually admonishing one of their own members in Bob Menendez for his actions. So what do you see as the number one thing you feel you can accomplish for the people of New Jersey?
You know, Bill, the people of New Jersey deserve better, right? And throughout this campaign, you talk a lot about abstract ideas of getting more for New Jersey, putting New Jersey first, and I think that's the right thing. But you have to believe there's actually differences can be made. Last week or so, I was down in Burlington, and this whole urban area strategic initiatives gives you so clearly the problem that we have in New Jersey. We have these right proper funding to support first responders for national for natural disasters or terrorist attacks, and the money goes to Philadelphia. You know, that's wonderful, and zero comes to New Jersey. The same thing in North Jersey. They use the New Jersey counties and the ones like Camden, Burlington, and Gloucester County, they count into the assessment of how much money the federal government should put into support beefing up the infrastructure so we're well prepared for natural disaster or terrorism, and zero of the money comes to New Jersey. There are so many things on infrastructure where New Jersey's getting the short end of the stick. And so I have to tell you, I've learned so much over these months that I am so confident that we're going to do so much better starting in January of getting a fair deal for the taxpayers of New Jersey to Washington treating New Jersey fair again.
Do you expect that the national parties are going to look at the seat and say, okay, this is a top target and we're going to play in New Jersey?
Well, I have to tell you, the Democrats have already, I think by this week, it's $2.5 million of outside money has already come in attacking me. I saw yesterday the Democratic Senate Campaign Committee was putting money into New Jersey. So they realize the voters of New Jersey have made a decision that it's time for change. And I'm the guy that's going to bring that change to the people of New Jersey. And I'm confident that people outside New Jersey see it. They're gonna make sure that we're fairly resourced to be balanced in the whole issue of how things work out. But Bill, our job is to make sure that people understand this is about New Jersey. New Jersey's gotten the short end of the stick. We're gonna deliver fairness for New Jersey, and this is about Menendez versus Hugin, and let's make that choice on November 6th and move this state forward with somebody who cares about outcomes, working with others, and putting people first, not just talk.